My name is Brandon Johnson, and this video continues my demonstration of the Siemens Somatic IT XFP Manufacturing Execution System platform. The key MES functionality in the life sciences industry is electronic batch records, or EBR, and XFP is a good example of an EBR implementation within an MES. In this segment, I will be reviewing some of the advantages of EBR and demonstrating how simple it is to design and reuse EBR elements within the MES system. As an example, let's take a look at this flow diagram and imagine an extremely simple workflow in which an operator needs to use a scale to weigh all of the items in a work order's bill of materials, identify a compounding tank, place the weighed materials into the previously identified tank, and begin mixing. During mixing, the temperature of the compound will be measured and the operator will be prompted to perform a temperature adjustment if required. Finally, the new stock will be declared and the EBR will automatically calculate the batch's yield. Let's begin with a quick tour of the design application. From here, an EBR designer has all of the tools he or she needs to develop electronic work instructions for inclusion in an EBR. The interface is very intuitive and works much like a standard word processing application. Text can be typed directly onto the canvas and can be organized into tables. Formatting options like font, text color, and background color are all easily configurable from the toolbar. These options allow the designer to control the look and feel of the EBR while organizing text instructions into logical and easily readable formats. The intuitive nature of the user interface means that EBR design is extremely flexible. It requires no prior programming skills and can be managed by the process subject matter experts rather than IT experts. In addition to plain text work instructions, operators can also include powerful XFP tags. These tags serve a variety of functions, like getting input from a keyboard or a barcode scanner, displaying the status of a piece of equipment or a material lot, generating a transaction to send data to an ERP or control system, prompting an operator for an electronic signature, as well as a variety of other advanced functions. Input fields can be configured to validate operator input automatically, preventing errors and ensuring data integrity. Numeric fields, for instance, can be defined to a specific decimal precision. Equipment identification tags can be configured to require a specific class of equipment. This could, for instance, prevent an operator from scanning a stationary tank when the process calls for a portable tank. Since the value of every field is captured and stored in the MES database, all of the batch data automatically becomes available for reporting. Work instruction data fields can even be linked together using contextual metadata to make reporting easier and more efficient. All of this ensures that the data captured in the EBR system can easily be transformed into usable information that can help to satisfy regulators as well as track and improve the manufacturing process. Once the work instructions have been created, they are sequenced in the process flow view. Tasks can easily be arranged for serial or parallel execution, and logic can be added to manage decisions and loops. Again, since all of the design is visual and very intuitive, it is quite simple for non-technical users to design and manage workflows. Similar to the XFP tags, workflow view contains powerful task elements that manage common requirements. The wait element, for instance, can be configured to pause execution for a predefined amount of time. This is useful for processes like mixing, where operators need to wait and allow a solution to mix for a certain amount of time before proceeding. Weighing is managed through the weighing element, which allows the operator to launch a special screen that integrates with and reads values directly from a scale via serial or USB connection. Equipment can be allocated to and released from a specific work order to trigger genealogy links that can be tracked after batch execution. Although each company's manufacturing process is unique and requires specific development of an EBR workflow, these standard out-of-the-box functions mean that common industry processes are predefined and an EBR designer does not need to reinvent the wheel to accomplish something as universal as weighing or combining ingredients. This combination of powerful out-of-the-box functionality and a simple, intuitive design environment enables the efficient creation of electronic batch records to fit any process. Once an EBR has been designed and approved for production, it can be merged with a work order and launched. Work orders can be generated locally within XFP or can be sent down via an interface with an ERP system. After a work order has been launched, the associated EBR becomes available within the execution interface for operators to begin production. Here we can see the EBR execution screen. This is where operators are able to navigate and interact with EBRs during the production process. The work order selection menu on the right-hand side allows the operator to search for and select from any work order that has been launched in the applicable work center. The status bar at the top of the screen shows the currently selected work order number, as well as other relevant information like the lot number and the name and description of the product being created. Clicking the workflow button allows access to the same workflow that we saw earlier in the design view. This allows the operator to look ahead to future tasks or select from any currently available tasks. Although future tasks are visible, it is impossible for the operator to execute tasks out of sequence. The EBR ensures that the production steps are performed in the correct order. If we return to the tasks view, we can see that the task list shows all of the tasks that are currently available to the operator for the current production step. In the case of parallel tasks that can be performed at the same time, multiple items may appear in this list simultaneously. At the moment, the only task available is to view the manufacturing context, so I will double-click to open that task. From here, we can see all of the process instruction text that was created during EBR design. The first task is just a summary of the work order's purpose. I've embedded the process flow chart image into the EBR. Contextual data like the bill of materials list, the work order number, and the BOM quantity are all available within the EBR and have been displayed to the operator. At the bottom, the operator is instructed to review the equipment procedure before proceeding. Clicking the link will open a PDF document that displays the equipment procedure. Once it has been reviewed, clicking the operator signature button allows the operator to input a username and password to record an electronic signature. Once the signature has been recorded, the task is complete and the operator is automatically returned to the task list and shown the next available task in the workflow. You can see the next task available in the workflow is material weighing, and we'll continue with that task in our next video segment.